coming up this Sunday on The Standpoint.
So the last incident that happened that really got me, that was my cutoff point, was our washroom was, even though it was male and female, the frontal parts where the sink and the mirror is the same. So you walk in before you go to the male or the female. So I'd finished and I was in front of the mirror and he just came in and just started groping me. And I actually exclaimed, and then there were two guys at the workplace. They didn't even come inside. So I actually slapped him and then I went out. I went to tell my then project officer right away and she said I should report to our HR, immediate HR. It was also a woman. I told her, she said she needed evidence that supported my story. I felt like that was one setback in a sense that me looking for evidence means me going back to the same person who is actually doing whatever he's doing to me. So I had to come back to my branch and still be whoever I was.
I'm sorry.
One time I was sent to a conference center to go and deliver some cleaning detergent to the cleaners, and I saw this man at the entrance. I was like, okay, I want to give you a lift. And since I grew up in the world of men, I'm cool. I can easily move with them. So I was in a car with this man going back to the office. He was like, can you give me a BJ? Can you suck my dick? And I'm like, you are driving. You expect me to do this? Oh, no. Then let me alight. And the man was like, no. So he told me, that's how I got to know ways can break people. He told me I'm like a fresh banana and very soon I'll rot and nobody will like to enjoy me.
And mind you, if you go and ask questions about who are being defiled, who are being raped, Muslims are being raped and defiled. Muslims are being assaulted. Okay. They are being harassed in their hijab. They are being harassed in their abaya, in their burqa.
Yeah.
If you cover your face, all your hands, why is it that on daily basis we have cases of 6 months, 2 years, 3 years, 6 years, being defiled? It's the mindset. Before people go ahead to do this, they plan it. So the problem is never the victim or the survivor. The problem is the perpetrator. The challenge is that it happens in the workplace. People are forcing you. People are pulling strings to force you to drop the case. Then the next thing, your pastor is calling you. Your imam is calling you. That drop the case.
Yeah,
you
bet me on.
You bet me on.
Exactly.